What's up, you all? And as requested, Miss Rachel Farrell, George Duke, with Every Breath I Take, 97. Was this during her prime? The 90s, right?
They ain't got a 240 up here now.
Come on.
Again, ladies and gentlemen, the inimitable Mr. George Duke.
Inimitable. It's a new one for me.
Once again and always.
Thank you. them keys. That man's bad. This was excellent. I loved it. Can I just say that Mr. George Duke and the band, absolutely, they were absolute fire. They were incredible. But Mr. George Duke on the keys, I mean, he just shredded those keys. Everything he did, I mean, I was captivated. I mean, just a perfect accompaniment, if that's the right way to say it. Just I can't say enough good things about him. I mean, he's a beast in his own right. Now, Miss Rachelle Farrell. I love her delivery. I love that soft, airy, breathy, kind of like babyish voice. I love when she does that. At times, the tone there is so pretty. And the dramatic shift from like the soft baby voice to the descending note, it for a lot of people that can be quite awkward, but for the way she was doing it, I loved it. I did every time she descended down into her lower range and went back up the way she did it, and the texture of her tone when she did it, I loved it every time. And it's just her delivery again. Her delivery is the big thing for me here. She is an absolute beast. And her mix, I saw at during the climaxes, when she do that long sustained belt, how I heard how it went from a heavy mix, and as she sustained it and went on, it got more and more solid into it turned into eventually like a full chest belt. And I heard somebody say in the comments that she doesn't really, she like only mixes, and that she, I don't know who that was, but anyway, like they accused her of like only mixing and not really doing full chest belts like that, but she did it here. when she was sustaining those two massive sustained belts, she did that. And I mean, that just takes skill in itself. The volume control in general in this performance, I mean, it's just it's epic. It is absolutely epic. I love her ad-libs here. I loved her kind of staccato styles vocals here and there, that quick sort of jazzy thing that she does. I love that. I love it. I mean, to me, she didn't do too much here. To me, I enjoyed everything she did. I enjoyed every ad-lib and just every ornamentation she placed in there. I loved it. And just her tone in itself, it can be so beautiful. And I think I prefer her when she's singing smooth and airy and it's just like an acoustic setting. And it's not. But when her and the band hit that climax together, when particularly the piano, and he was going off on the piano and she was holding that sustained belt together, that was too much. That was just too much for me. You know what I mean? I mean, I just had to, at that point, I was just goosebumps galore, and I mean, it's just, it's a lot. That is a lot. I love it, and it's epic. But it's overwhelming to me to hear just the piano going full, stop, and her voice on that. That is so, that's just an outer body type, you know, moment. I mean, that's like heaven for me to hear something like that. And it doesn't happen often, in music. I mean, I've been doing all these reactions. It's very rare when a band and the lead singer goes off at the same time. It's like a, you know, it's like a clash, but a good one. You know what I mean? It's like a bomb going off, and it's just overwhelming to my senses, but again, in a great way. Anyway, this was beautiful. I mean, just beautiful. Thank you all for liking and subscribing. Please continue to support your favorites. Peace.